Several weeks before the massacre in Norway, CBN News went to Oslo. We went to investigate reports that that nation's experiment with Muslim immigration and multiculturalism had gone terribly wrong, that Muslim radicalism was growing, along with violence and intimidation against non-Muslims. In the wake of the killings, some on Norway's left call the fear of Islamization a conspiracy theory. But the victims of Islam are real, and they are mostly Norway's women. They are problems Norway has never faced before. Every woman in Norway does not have full human rights. There are women in this country who are denied their rights by their families, and they live in fear for their lives. At the Red Cross office in Oslo, Monica Berge and Ann-Marthe Stifjeld take calls from Norwegian girls who face honor violence, forced marriage, and genital mutilation.
We have girls who call, and we really get this bad feeling in the stomach that something is seriously wrong. Most of the girls tell us that I wouldn't think about it, or I never thought it would happen, because I live in Norway, I have my friends, I go to school, and I never thought it would happen.
They not only live in Norway, but they were born in Norway, and they speak Norwegian, but their rights are not protected, and they are controlled by their families.
And a lot of them have been threatened or beaten up.
Hege Storhaug was a self-described naive left-wing journalist when an encounter with an immigrant woman changed her life and her career.
In 1992, as a journalist, I met a young Norwegian-born Pakistani woman, only 18 years old. And she had been married at gunpoint in Pakistan to a second cousin.
Storhaug now works full-time to protect immigrant women and girls from forced marriage, genital mutilation and honor violence. Women, she says, who have been abandoned by the Norwegian government and deprived of their rights as citizens. Like four Norwegian sisters all sent to Gambia for genital mutilation.
They were aged 3 to 9 years old. All four were dumped in the village in Gambia, the village of origin of the family. And they were female genital mutilated in the jungle, traditional. They have been stripped from the possibility to become a full member of this society. And we have allowed it. We have allowed it.
Storhaug, who works on behalf of the rights of women, has been called a racist and an Islamophobe by the left in Norway. Something else that Muslim immigration appears to have brought to Norway is what some here call a rape epidemic. Recent police statistics showed that in the capital of Oslo, 100% of assault rapes between strangers were committed by immigrant non-Western males, and 9 out of 10 of their victims were native Norwegian women. Some blonde Norwegian women have reportedly begun dyeing their hair black, and many travel only in groups. Kristen Spitznogel is a therapist who has counseled some of the rape victims, and she's been attacked in the Norwegian media for saying what many will not, that the rape problem is primarily Muslim men raping non-Muslim women, and any woman who does not dress modestly and wear the Muslim headscarf could be considered by some Muslim men as fair game.
For them, I think the hijab is a symbolic marker which separates the submissive, proper Muslim women from what they see as the Norwegian horse. But when I say horse, I'm really just referring to their own words. This is what they told the journalists.
Spitznogel says Norway's left-wing establishment has been blaming the victims, because the whole notion that Islamic culture is dangerous to women is very politically incorrect here. Hannah Herland is author of the best-selling book Alarm, Thoughts on a Culture in Crisis.
And not all values, some of them are excellent, but not all values from Islamic countries or cultures are excellent to bring into the European society. And I think many times the Norwegians fear to speak about that in fear of being called a racist.
But it's hard to call a Muslim immigrant a racist for speaking out against his fellow Muslims. Walid al-Kubaisi is a respected Norwegian writer and a Muslim who came from Iraq. He told us he's concerned about radical Islamic elements within the larger Muslim community in Norway.
We have a problem. Nobody, all deny, nobody say that. We have a big problem, but this will give a bad result in the future.
As in other European cities, parts of Oslo are now Muslim zones and may be subject to Sharia law or to the rules of local imams. When we interviewed Walid in June, no one had any idea that a crazed gunman would start killing people because of Muslim immigration. But Al-Kubaisi made what now feels like a chilling prediction.
You think there will be a backlash, a reaction against immigrants?
Clash of civilization. It will happen.
Civil war?
We don't know. I am not a prophet. But something will happen. Something will happen. I don't know. But I feel it.
Some on the left in Europe are trying to use the Oslo massacre to stifle criticism of Islam. But not talking about it won't make Norway's problems go away. Dale Hurd, CBN News, in Oslo, Norway.